So, I think we are live, huh? Let's see. The sound, can you hear me, everybody? Let's see if the sound is working. We are about to start in 2 minutes. I'm checking the sound here, okay? You're gonna be drawing Frida Kahlo. The picture that I'm using as a reference is the one you can see up here. And I think I have the link on the description of the video. Let me just continue checking here. So if you're online, type something. You know, are you gonna draw? Are you gonna just watch? Tell me. And if you're gonna draw, I really would love to see the picture later on. You can send me through Facebook, Instagram, or my email. That's info@shelvasal.com. And it'll be cool, right? Let's just enjoy this time together. I have my coffee as well, as always. Later is gonna be beer or wine, I don't know. And let's go through this interesting moment in history. Tragedy is always somehow comical. We have to have some fun to keep our sanity, right? Okay, so I'm not sure yet if the volume is working. I'm just waiting here. I think so. I'm waiting for confirmation. So I'm using, oh yeah, it's working, cool, thank you. I'm using here a gesso board, 18 by 24. I was planning on doing something smaller, but last minute I changed my mind. I think Frida Kahlo deserves a larger surface. I'm not gonna stay on this tiny view for long. We are gonna be drawing with this larger view so you can see exactly what's being going on the surface. And here on the side, you can see the reference image, but you can also go to the to Google and make it larger, or download it and print and put on your site, or you can come to this video later and use as a reference. Okay, I'm gonna be using a charcoal. I use usually to start. You can start with vine, willow, or in my case, I'm using this nitram soft. I use it at the beginning to mark the main shapes and position and everything. But I also use a lot of compressed charcoal. I might later, you know, that's my second video, so I'm still learning how to do it. I'm gonna add some links to the products that I usually use to make it easier for y'all. I'm also gonna use some sponge, different shapes. I use things that are, you know, I use for makeup Or this sponge here, it was something I found in a box, you know, to keep the products in place. You just can cut out a piece in the shape that's good for you, the size that you want. It's just a kind of a vehicle to drag powder around. You can also use those fancy sponge brushes. That also works well. And I'm gonna be using my kneaded eraser that I keep, you know, all the time moving around and changing and cleaning it. So it's a good thing to use. And what else I'm gonna be using today? Lots of general pencils. Usually I just stick to the 6B and HB. Some erasers, different shapes. Actually, the other one, I don't know what is that. I'm gonna be using this and also an X-Acto knife for fine details because I use a gesso board. So I can just scrape the surface to make it very white. If it's a paper, I really wouldn't recommend. You might just make a hole in your paper. So that's why I really like the gesso board. Let's see what else here. You can also use some fancy erasers. Can you hear that? There's a little motor here. That's also cool. It works. There are many different brands for that. And let's see. And my fingers. Yeah, because I use this glove. I don't like to work without gloves with charcoal because it's too messy, and also our hands usually are very oily, and then you're gonna have your fingerprints all over the surface if you like it, if it's gonna give some texture, but I don't like it, and I think it I can't control the surface very well with that. Okay, so let me just check one more thing here on the video, and then you can start talking a little bit about Frida Kahlo, and then we start drawing. Okay, so I'm gonna go back to that. Oh, why? That's my second video for this series. I decided to do that because I'm working from home. So usually when I'm in the studio, my door is open, so the public comes in and I can talk to random people about random subjects, and I like it a lot and I'm missing it. And also because we are going through a very hard moment with this pandemic, and I think it's a moment to share. We have to share what we have, and sharing is caring. I always tell that to my kids, and I'm sharing with y'all my time, my energy, and my drawing technique. That's what I know, that's what I can do, and I hope that maybe that's gonna touch somebody else's heart. Maybe that's gonna help you to go through a few hours of your day at home. Maybe that's gonna help you to improve your technique, your drawing skills. And after all this craziness in the world is finished, we will have improved a lot together, or at least had spent some positive time together. So let's do it, right? And it's a moment to share good things. And that's my goal here, my own goal. So, okay. That being said, I decided to draw. I like to draw faces, people, pictures. Now I've been moving my personal work into a more narrative, I would say. And but for the purpose here, because I'm gonna try to have a session of 1.5 hours about that, I'm gonna stick just to a face, and let's use that to draw people that can help us to go through this very difficult moment with some, and learning something from others that had gone through that, with resilience, patience, and courage. So I'm choosing important characters in history that we can learn from them. So it's not just about the drawing, but it's also about getting curious and having the chance to maybe later on go and dive into literature or some articles to know more about the this character's life. Now I'm sticking to real people, but I might change to even some fictional characters. And I really appreciate your input. If you have any suggestions, you can type in the comments or shoot me a message, and I'm gonna add that to my list. Okay. For example, I'm also considering maybe going through to draw some of the characters that I'm reading now, for example. Like now I'm reading two books, The Plague from Albert Camus, to understand what's going on in the world and how people react to the situation, and also Meditations from Marcus Aurelius. So maybe I can draw some of the characters in The Plague or some scenes that I can see, and then you can maybe get to know more about Albert Camus, who knows. Or maybe I can draw a cast representing Marcus Aurelius, and you should take a look on the meditations. That's gonna help you to keep your day based on some discipline and helping you to cope with this uncertainty and this unknown territory that we are moving towards. Okay, that being said, so my first character on Monday, it was Anne Frank. Now I decided to do Frida Kahlo. Why? Okay, Anne Frank, she was confined for 25 months in a very tiny room, yeah, with other families, not just her own family. And you see amazing stuff that young girl she wrote and that she could process inside her because she had time to look inside her. So I think we can maybe do the same in this moment. We are now, maybe let's stop, calm down, and try to look inside us. And Frida Kahlo, man, she was confined into her body because when she was 6 years old, she got polio. So that was already a big thing for her because I think it was on her right side, right leg and foot. Everything was not so well developed. Imagine, so she was limping, and that's hard for a kid, for adolescent to go through that. And she had to, I would say, to be very strong or stronger than others for being different. That's why, for example, she was wearing just long skirts to hide that. And now that became her identity, her visual identity. So sometimes things that happen in our life, maybe we, if we use that in a very positive way, we can always transform things and incorporate that in our identity. That's gonna make us stronger. And also I feel that I have a kind of a connection with Frida. When I started doing a few self-portraits, I kind of got really inspired by her because I think she painted about 70 self-portraits. And she said, I'm going to paraphrase her because I don't, I might even look up the phrase, the sentence on my phone, but she said something that she was drawing her because she was the thing that she knew better, that was herself, right? She was spending lots of time alone, so she knew herself a lot. That's why she was drawing herself. And I would say that during the past 5 years, I've been doing this hard work of looking inside myself as well. Having this changing career from chemical engineering to a full-time visual artist. And then adopting our kids and becoming a mom suddenly, you know, with two kids, 5 and 6 years old, from, I was not really, I would say, I was not prepared for it biologically during 9 months, and just suddenly my kids appeared. Of course, psychologically I was being prepared, but it was kind of a shock, right? And that, when those moments, they happen in your life, it's better to calm down, slow down, and look inside. So I've been doing that a lot. And then so far I did two self-portraits and I really like them. One got the prize at the Portrait Society of America, Tri-State, that I'm blowing a house and the house is becoming birds. And the other one, I'm just trying to kind of rip off my chest and the marks and the cracks I filled with gold leaf. And I called it kintsugi because of the Japanese technique. And they're very meaningful, representing my deep thoughts and how I'm feeling. So maybe that's something y'all could do now that we have to be stuck at home, those who can't do that. Or maybe this crisis outside, it's making us to either freeze, fight or flight, you know, we are in that moment. So if you are feeling frozen, maybe it's the moment to look inside and analyze what you like in life, what you don't like, and or why you were feeling frozen and why you're so scared, because then you can learn a lot about yourself and maybe calm down and see things in a different perspective. And I think Frida, she was very courageous facing all those problems since very early age. So maybe that prepared her for the big accident that happened in her life when she was about 18 years old. She was in a bus and then the bus crashed. I think in a car came and crashed in the bus. And then the handrail came and kind of impaled her through the hips, and horrible situation. And she had to wear a full cast and stay for months on a bed for recovery. And after that, her life was a life in pain, a physical pain. Imagine that. So, and then later on in life, she ended up having to amputate her right leg. And that's why I chose the sentence, feet, what do I need you for when I have wings to fly? So, man, this woman, she was confined into her body and still she had this freedom to express her amazing world that was inside her on canvases. And now, till now, we are all talking about her, learning with her. So I think if you are capable of transforming all that pain and fear, there's a lot of power in pain and fear, you know? There's power for destruction, and also there's a lot of power to create something new about that. So connecting with my self-portrait with the house, blowing the house, representing destroying a reality we have now in the present. But you don't need to panic, because those little pieces of the house in my self-portrait, if you see, they become little birds in the end. And those birds represent, you know, hope, new beginnings. They are going to go to a new land and something new is going to happen. And maybe that's it's one option, it's an exit for a reality that maybe you are frozen and thinking that nothing good is going to happen in the future. Yeah, and I truly believe that we have power to change things, and everything starts in here, you know, here. So let's keep our mind sane by doing something that's useful. In my case, I can draw, so I'm here. So, if you can see here, no, on the picture, on my side here, so Frida is laying on the bed and painting and drawing. So her space was really limited, and she did what she could with that. So now look around where you are, what you can do, and now even internet we have. So our reach is much bigger, wider, and just think what we can do now to share and add something positive and good to the community around you, okay? Alrighty, so if you have a kid at home, like my case, I would recommend you to get this book. You might, I'm not sure if you have a Kindle version, but you can definitely buy it online and have it delivered to your home. And I'm really super fan of this series, Who Was? we have here at home many characters. I don't have Frida Kahlo yet, but I have many others. I might acquire that very soon to read with my kids. So here, I think you're gonna, if you have a kid at home, that's a good option. Okay. Alrighty. So, if you have any comments, you can write on the chat and I'll be looking at it during my next break. And then let's start drawing. Okay. Mm-hmm. I'm gonna start playing some music here. You can listen to your music over there. And let's enjoy some time together. Mm-hmm. Okay, hang in there. Let's see. Music. I have here my Pandora. Something changed. Mm-hmm. Sensations. Okay. Why is nothing? Okay, now yes. It was not that what I was listening. Okay, it's Pandora, so I have to listen to the advertisement first. Okay, let's start. Okay. I might add in the future some flowers with golden leaf for her hair. I love it. Okay, guys, let's do it. I hope to finish that in about an hour and a half. And let's see. I'm using here my mall. It's a tip from a good friend. That's a is a back scratcher. So it's a good thing to rest your hand and work on the details of the drawings. I'll move on a little lower here. Okay, let's start. As I said in a previous video, I like to work thinking that the drawing is a sculpture rather than a really drawing. There are many techniques, okay? There's no right or wrong way to approach it. Sometimes I measure, sometimes I don't, but I like to keep it very fluid and easy to make adjustments. So you're gonna see me adding and removing powder all the time, because in my mind it's as if I'm working with the sculpture, you know. And I like to just kind of have fun with that. So if you have any questions, please type something there in the comments. I'm gonna answer later when I stop here to rest my hand. And then if you have your material there with you, just draw along, you know? Prepare your setup at home and let's draw. Any questions about, you know, which supplies I'm using, please just type your question. I'm gonna share as much as I can with y'all. So I'm kind of toning the surface. And I'm really thinking here how I'm gonna do the end. Most likely I'm not gonna draw everything on the bottom. But I kind of like her jewelry. I might do something with that here. Yeah. You know, good thing about the gesso is that, for example, I can even come with a, let me see here if you can see, a sandpaper and I can just, you know, sand it down and have it wiped again. But of course, with the eraser, it's gonna be more than enough, but always have this option. Okay, I'm just trying to feel where I'm gonna place things. Just having some fun now. Not really worried about details, or I might even add some of the little flowers in the back or suggest them. It seems fun, maybe. So I might even tone on the sides a little bit to have some gray areas to play with, to have mid-tones. I might do it. Very good. Here's gonna be kind of her hair. Yeah, somewhere here. Maybe the end of her head there. And the end here, I think so, yeah. And then you're gonna have mid-tones on the back so I can play with the little flowers. It's gonna look cute. And here, I'm gonna add lots of flowers coming out of the... Sometimes I like to make the drawing going out of the frame, you know, as if it's larger than the frame. Oh, my hair is coming to my face, it's really bothering. Okay. You see, I'm using the sponge as an eraser. It's a very simple tool. You don't need to go, you know, to expensive stuff. Keep it simple. Keep it simple. Very minimalist. Don't need so many fancy stuff, guys. Usually, when I'm at the studio, I work standing. Here today, I'm sitting. I think for the camera, I think next videos, I'm gonna change a little bit of my setup so you can have a better view. I'm using my fingers all the time. Kind of, I like to feel the surface. You know, keep dragging it. And maybe in the future I might try sculpture. Let's see. It seems cool. And as I said, I really nowadays, I don't follow one way to do things. Kind of, I let the drawing decide that to me. Sometimes I go and I define one entire area, or sometimes, no, I go around. It depends, really. Nowadays, I try not to be so rigid for that, you know, just let it go, like Frozen. Oh, yeah. finish this live streaming, my goal is to edit the video a little bit, so I might zoom in some areas and let's see. I'm still learning some of those tools for editing the videos, so hang in there. The goal is just to get better at it. So now I'm using here the compressed. The problem with the compressed on top of the willow or something softer is that once you apply it, you're gonna drag out of the surface what you had laid down already. You know, I don't mind it much because usually I use the willow to place things. And I kind of like to mix that, and also it gets a, I think through the video maybe you don't see it, but once you mix that, you get some warm shades, and it looks good if you see it in person. I'll try to add a high definition picture to my YouTube as soon as I upload the video, so you can see what I'm talking about. You could also, you know, just draw with the compressed all the way. That would also work. The drawing would be a little bit darker, and then sometimes you want that atmosphere, so I would go with the compressed all the way. And it's interesting because as I'm streaming now, I can somehow I focus more. It really feels like as if I'm at the studio with the door open. It's really cool. You can always get the sandpaper and just rub the charcoal stick there, and then you have lots of powder available for you. Then I grab with my finger so I can draw with that. It's a way to really go soft in a way that you can erase the surface easily. And you know, it's all about keeping looking at your reference and adding more powder here, erasing powder there, like a sculpture. Let's go. You see, now I haven't finished here. I'm just placing some spots, some shades that I think are important, or very dark spots that I think are important. And then I usually move to another area, and then I add more information that I see that are gonna help me to kind of organize myself on the surface. You know, I can compare the distance, and you can squint your eyes to make sure that things are placed roughly on the correct spot. You can always move around later on. So I decided to add this dark area here to help me anchor this spot. That's gonna help me to see if the eyes and eyebrows, they are really in proportion to the size of the head, you know. That's really helping me here. And then I can move to another area, and kind of, if I compare the height of this area here with the height of the other side of her head, and then if I look down, I can compare where the hair ends and starts the little flower in comparison to the end of her eyebrows. Can you see that? Yeah. I don't need to define that. I just mark and leave it there. Because maybe I don't want to define that. Maybe I just want to keep a mark. And then the drawing is going to be more interesting and fresh. And I let you, the viewer, with your eye, to complete the drawing. You don't need to draw everything. You can, of course, but it's not the way I like to work. And you see her ears are kind of ending about this height here. And I just mark the end of the hair. Just leave it there for now. Don't need to do more. And if you don't like it, you can always come and kind of try to erase everything. Come with the eraser here, you know, and remove that powder. So, really forgiving surface. I love it. And I think it's all about really enjoying what you're doing. Man, you have no idea, guys. I could be doing this here for hours. Sometimes I even forget to eat. So that's why it's good that I have a family and that I have to keep my kids alive. So that makes me stop and go prepare food and do other stuff. Or I would be here just drawn, totally hypnotized by it. Seriously. If you notice in the reference picture, I really like the light. You have some light here on this side of her head. It's really, really a beautiful spot. It's a useful, spot to mark. It's not gonna be super white, but you can even mark. That's gonna help you to compare other areas of. Can be an anchor spot. So, but remember, there are many ways to draw. Some people, they like to use projector. You can gain some time with that. But in my case, if I'm using projectors or gridding, I end up, you know, not having that much fun. And I feel that my drawing becomes super tight if I'm doing it. Because I try to do something that's realistic, but not hyper-realistic. I like to have some marks, some texture around. So, and give more like a painterly effect in some areas. later, when I come to those flowers, I'm gonna have a lot of fun here. Especially if I end up adding gold leaf. I'm gonna love it. Can you see that her nose started to pop? I don't know why. Usually, the nose is one of my favorite parts to draw. And making that to pop, you know, it's so cool. It seems like it's coming out of the paper. And the fun thing about the gesso board, that if you see very close, there's a lot of texture here. It looks really cool. You can achieve that with paper as well. But I feel that if you need to erase something, with the paper, is not that forgiving. And later on, I'm gonna varnish this piece so I can just hang as a painting. And you have, I feel that you have a better experience observing the image without the glass in front of it. I like it.
here's some paint. Her nose to guide me. I'll come back here later. Making sure I'm here at the correct height. If I need to move some stuff around. Usually I start with the right eye. I think I never started with the left, I don't know why. And you, usually when you draw with the left or right. Have you thought about that? I'm right-handed, maybe that if I don't know. If you're left-handed, do you start with the left eye? Never thought about it, maybe. Just adding some marks. Later I'm gonna come back to this area here. So imagine her pain now during this picture. Yeah.
course, I don't know, but most likely she was using some medication to cope with the pain, but still, I don't know, I'm so far, I'm lucky, I have no sorts of illnesses or anything that keeps me in pain all the time. It's hard to imagine. When I have headaches, it's already, oof, my gosh, I need something to stop that. I can't just feel the headaches for 20 minutes. It's already, you know, horrible. Imagine her the entire life. And creating something to express that, or she would explode. So maybe we should be creating more instead of exploding on others, you know? Let's use the power of our pain or our fear to do something positive. There's a lot of power in pain and fear. Lots of power. Imagine with the pulp, with the charcoal. Okay, the other eye now. If you arrived now there, just set up your drawing, you know, station, and let's be drawing together. And please send me the picture of your finished work. I would love to see. I'm planning on having my next live drawing session on Friday, same time, 5 p.m. I haven't decided yet the subject. I don't know yet. I had a list here on my sketchbook, so I can take a look. Oh, Sunday, during our family mythology study, We do some mythology study, all sorts of mythology. And we read this Comanche tale about the blue bonnets. And you have this little girl who sacrificed her doll. And I might Google that. I'm not going to be giving details now because I think it's better when people, they search for things and now I have time, stay at home, right? So search for the Comanche tale that describes how the blue bonnet, a symbol of Texas, right? How they started. So we have this little girl that sacrificed something that was really important for her doll, for the community, so the rain could come. I might draw her, who knows. I was planning on having my daughter as my model for this story, so I might do her face. But then later on, I'm planning on also be recording all my drawings, and I might draw this tale, and I'm gonna share with them. I'm not gonna be recording all my sessions, slide for that, for a narrative drawing, but I can at least draw my daughter's face, or I can draw part of the drawing with the all online. I'm gonna be doing lots of online stuff now, I think. I can't wait to go back for my life drawing groups. How I miss them. As I say in Portuguese, it's minha cachaça. So far, she's looking younger, but that's gonna be corrected soon. I think it's also because of the hair. It seems that she has two buns here. And I might kind of integrate her with the background. Usually do that. Maybe her hair integrated with the back. And I'm gonna suggest some flowers. I'm not sure if I'm gonna define everything down here, but something with the jewelry I'm gonna do for sure. That's something I need to see. Let's see the process. Have to be here, zooming in and out my reference picture. Oh my music. What happened? Play, please. Okay, again, the advertisement first, no problem. I love when I go to the background like that. That's Frida. And maybe I'm gonna make her vanish in the background here. Who knows? Never worry to apply the charcoal, you know? You always can get it up. You always can erase it if you don't like it, okay? So just have some fun. Make some fun marks. So again. Mm-hmm. Whoops. I'm holding the easel. Sorry. Too big forehead. Not just that. Yeah, this sad. I might make her vanishing in the background. I'm not sure yet. Because I want to have jewelry down here marked somehow. So I need to figure out how I'm going to do it. And you don't have to draw everything, you know, you just suggest some areas. And always your brain can complete the drawing. Like when we are talking to people, you don't keep seeing everything at the same time. You see the mouth moving and then you look to the eye and, you know. So the other areas you're not looking at becomes kind of blurred, but your brain completes that. And maybe her earring also might be a little bit kind of defined. Let's see. I feel that the compressed charcoal, when I press with my finger, it really gets into the gesso. So that's why I can go darker and maybe build more layers. Just want to suggest her mouth. I'm not gonna be drawing everything. So, for example, I wanna bring the focus to the area around her eyes. So it's better to add more marks around it and everything else be a little bit blurred. So naturally you bring the focus and attention to that area. Just correcting here a little bit her nose. And I feel that for the eyes, what's really important is to balance the amount of white, you know, the, if you get the amount of white correct, you're almost there, you know. So I'm using the sponge. You know, different sponges can give you very interesting shapes and marks. So I recommend you to try it and find what works best for you. I set it in, like, trying to decide what I'm gonna do here on the bottom of the drawing because I wanna leave it mostly undefined, but I like her jewelry. So I'm in doubt what to do here. Let's see. Now in the video you can see some warm shades. Now it happens when I'm mixing the vine or willow or the soft neutron charcoal with the compressed. It really happens. I feel the compressed is a little bit cooler. So it makes this contrast. Just thinking what I'm gonna do here in the bottom. I might tone almost everything down here gray and then just bring some highlights. Maybe not on the edges. I like to keep the edges undefined because if I apply a floating black frame it looks cool. So I'm just gonna tone a few areas around. Okay, my mouth fell, but I'm gonna pick it later. Yeah. just keep toning the back, making some interesting marks. Now that I'm sitting, it's a little bit more difficult to do it. That's why I usually like draw standing, but I can't move now or my camera is gonna go crazy. Okay, powder all over the place in here. On my computer. It's like working in mining, you know? I don't smoke, but I'm pretty sure my lungs now are not looking good. I'm not really drawing everything. I'm just suggesting it. Okay. So you can already see her jaw. But I don't want to draw that. But I want to mark the lines of her scarf or shawl or whatever. And I'm going to mark some spots for the jewelry. Then, for example, if I want, because the background is getting very dark, it's nice to add a line that's gonna mark some edges of her hair. So it's endless possibilities. But I kind of like that she's vanishing down here, merging with the background. I'm still gonna add some of the flowers. Yeah. I can just add some details on maybe one of the earrings, who knows? Maybe here, this one is gonna be good. Because here you're gonna have maybe more flowers. Just trying to mark a little bit more of her jaw here. So I'm gonna be doing that, you know, for like those series with other characters. I think I'm really enjoying that. So I'm on that for a long run. And glad to be able to share that. And I hope it becomes useful to some of you all out there. I hope this craziness in the world ends soon, so I can go back to teach my classes. I had lots of workshops in my mind to do this year. We were planning lots of classes here in Houston at this place, Creation, but I don't know what's gonna happen now. Can you see the light spots coming? Because there was a little flower behind the earring. Sometimes you have to draw what is around of the object you want to define. You don't draw the object itself. Then some magic happens. I'm just gonna suggest her ear here. There's a light spot. Maybe down there. There. Okay. Then more flowers. So I have something here. And I have jewelry that I really wanted to add. I'm gonna make it a little bit shorter than the real thing because of the placement of her head. I'm missing some. It's gonna be weird if I go really down there. Just gonna suggest it. You see what I mean? I don't know, maybe before setting this board here, I might have touched it with my bare hands, and now I can see on the sides some of my fingerprints. So, but that's not a problem. I can just come with the sandpaper later and sand it down, and it's gonna be cool. Flowers. flower here and there. So I like this flower in the black in the background, you know. They did a great job for the picture. I think it makes your eyes moving around the image. It's super cool. So I'm not drawing everything on the flowers on her head, it's just suggesting the light of the, some petals. And then your eye completely draw, you know. Yeah. And then later on I'm gonna have some fun with my gold leaf. I don't know where to place it exactly now, but I see many possibilities here. Yeah, I'm coming to 1.5 hours now. I think I was talking during the first 15, 20 minutes, I think. So it's about 1 hour in the drawing. I think you're good so far. I might be doing that for more 30 minutes. Let's see. If I don't finish now, and the next 30 minutes, I might have to stop because it's gonna be our family dinner time here. And then I can record later the rest of the process, and I add to the final video before uploading it. Okay, y'all can gonna have the whole thing. Because as I said, this is something for me to be as if I'm working with my studio. Open, you know, my door open, sharing everything that I can, and I hope that it's useful to some of you out there. And please, if you have questions, just type in the comments or shoot me a message on Facebook, Instagram, or email, and I'll be glad to interact with you and answer. Whoops. Again. If you were here and, oh my gosh, if you could see my computer now full of charcoal. Oh my gosh, I hope it survives this session. Then I have to vacuum. Thank you. said, I'm trying to not define everything on the bottom of her face, just suggest it, as if she's vanishing in the background. Let's try to make some fun marks. Maybe I might add some of the flowers on top of her. Let's see. Could be something interesting. Might look good. All the lines are, you know, in this diagonal here, so I might change something a little bit to be more interesting. Yeah, oops. Yeah, so I might even add some of those lines up there and see how it looks. You see, it gives a very painterly effect. I kind of like it. Let's work on the flowers in her head a little bit. So you can squint your eyes and see where the shades, you know. To split the session in two, because I'm really have some fun, and then you can work on the background more. Now here I'm using the compressed again to make some strong marks. I like in the end to come making, you know, some crazy marks, adding some interesting shapes and lines.
squinting your eyes and see, you know, the values, where else you can, like, make some adjustments. The problem is that the side here is bothering me a little bit. If I'm in one area and I feel that I'm trying to fix it, but it starts to take too long, I just abandon it and then I come back later. Because sometimes if you fix another area of the drawing, then the overall image is gonna have a different impact on that area, you know? So maybe what you need to adjust is not what you think you have to adjust, it's something else. Now, after placing a lot of things, I think her nose is a little bit too wide. No, it's not. Just the lighting, I have to make some adjustments. Yeah, I can get that good. Suggest her smile here. Very simple, simple smile here. I feel that either this shade's a little bit too long, or I place it in the mouth too high. I think make a small adjustment here. Yeah, I think the mouth could be that's right here. Oh yeah, I think this shade here, that's not quite. That's more like, more again, we don't need to draw the entire thing. It's just to suggest it. And there are some few spots that are important, you know, a few light spots that they do the trick. It's, you just sometimes need one spot. And that spot is the most important. You just need to start seeing things like that. Sometimes it's so hard to know where to, when to stop, right? Oh man, I keep adding details and things, and sometimes I regret. But the good thing about this media is that it's really forgiving. Now I'm using a cotton ball, because then I can go very, very light on my change of values. It can go, it can be very careful. Then I come back, again with my finger. And but I really want her to be, you know, being vanished like this. But not too much. You know? I still want to see her jaw defined. Yeah. Now you're getting there. I might stop, okay, in the next few minutes, but I'm gonna go back, come back, maybe tomorrow. But for sure, the final video, I'm gonna combine everything, both sessions, so you can see the whole thing. But for sure, I'll be back tomorrow. Yeah, I think so. To complete that, because I really need to work on the background. I'm having some visions here on how I wanna work this background. Yeah, I think for today I'm gonna stop right here. Let me move the canvas so you can see where we are now. So, I think I'm closer. Whoops. Can you see? So, we're going to be working tomorrow on more details and also work on the background. I really want to add more flowers to the background, but keeping her mouth and jaw undefined, I think that's going to look good in the end. Okay? All right, so now I'm gonna have a break, and tomorrow I'm gonna record more. And thank you again for sticking, for hanging there, sticking together. Let's be sharing and spreading what we have that's good in us, or that we think is good in us, but being truthful, opening our heart to the community, and we are gonna all go through this hard moments together. And when this all is done, we are gonna look back and see that we used this time to create something using all this power that's inside us, with this
fear, you know, not knowing what's gonna happen. Let's just get this power and transform that into something useful. Okay, that's the goal. See y'all tomorrow, okay? I'm gonna connect tomorrow, maybe tomorrow morning, but don't worry, I'm gonna combine the videos and you're gonna have everything uploaded later on, okay? Bye bye, guys.